moisturizing, all-natural face cream. Can you make one at home yourself? Absolutely! Just watch this video and I promise you that at the end you're gonna be able to make your own cream, lotion or moisturizer at home. Hello everyone, my name is Olga Larnaudie. I live in French Alpes and I'm a natural cosmetic formulator. Here on my channel I want to share with you my ideas and my recipes and to help you to make your beauty routine a little bit greener and safer for you and for our planet. Today in store you can find any kind of moisturizing cream. There are millions of brands. Does it even make sense to make your own cream when you can buy almost anything? Well, of course it does, because when you make your own cosmetics, you are in control. You know exactly what's inside your cream or lotion, but it's not the only reason, because when you make your own cosmetics, you spend money to buy ingredients, and then you make your cream and lotion with those ingredients. And finally, your skin gets actually 100% of care you paid for. And it is different when it goes to commercial products, because when you buy cream or lotion in store, you pay, say, I don't know, $10. The cost of the actual product, the cream that you're gonna apply on your skin, is around maybe $1, and $9 it's packaging, marketing, logistics, and blah blah blah. So you actually pay $10, but your skin gets care for $1. And when you make cosmetics, you pay $10 to buy ingredients, your skin gets care for $10. So it makes sense to make your own cosmetics. It is cost effective, it's natural, it's safe, and you know what? It's fun. If you really want to make high quality cream and lotion at home, then you would probably need to buy two pieces of equipment that you don't have already at home. High precision weight scale. This one is not very expensive. The price is around $10 and you can easily find it on the different websites. And the second piece of equipment I actually advise you to buy is a mixer, small mixer like this, hand mixer. It is also not expensive and you can find it on different websites, but when you make a small batch, like maybe 50 grams of cream or 100 grams of cream, this one comes very handy. What else you're gonna need? You're gonna need some glass beakers. I'm using this glass beakers, but you can actually use a regular Pyrex glass that you can find on your kitchen. The important thing is that it has to be heat proof, because we're gonna put it in hot water. So before doing this, make sure your glass can stand heating. You can also need some spoons. You can use the regular spoons and protection gloves. Gloves will protect your skin and will protect your product from contamination. And also we're going to use some alcohol. I'm using ethanol, 70% diluted ethanol, to disinfect my tools and working space, but you can actually take regular rubbing alcohol. I put it in a spray bottle and with it I'm going to prepare all my materials. And also you need a pH test stripes. You can easily find it on the different websites. Make sure that you order stripes of wide range, from 0 to 14. About ingredients, or what we're going to use to make our own cream and lotion. Oils and butters, because we make natural cosmetics and we work with natural oils, with natural butters. And actually the choice is really big. You can find different kind of oils, different kind of butters. Which oil or butter to choose, it depends on your budget, it depends on your skin type, and I'm gonna leave some useful information about the choice of oils and butters in the text box below this video. And today, to keep things simple, we're gonna use two oils, jojoba oil and sweet almond oil, and one butter. We're gonna use shea butter. Those oils and butter provide a lot of benefits for your skin. They moisturize, they protect your skin, and those are pretty common oils and butters. You can easily find it on different websites or in stores. Second group of ingredients, it's water or hydrazole. Because we're talking about lotion, lotion consists of two parts, oils and water. In cosmetics, in natural cosmetics, so we use purified water or distilled water, or we use hydrozols. And the hydrozol you can order on different websites as well, but actually you can also make your own hydrozol at home if you have a garden. And in this video I have already shown how you can make your own hydrozol at home with regular stove pot. The next ingredient we're gonna use is emulsifier. We cannot avoid this type of ingredient because in our lotion we have oils, butters, and we have water and hydrozol. If you just take water and add some oil in this water, you're gonna see that oil is gonna float on the surface of the water. They're not gonna mix together. In order to make a lotion with this creamy, smooth texture where oils and butters are well mixed, we need this special type of ingredient, emulsifier. It has a very specific type of molecule which can actually connect both to water and to oil, and it can bond it together. And today we have a lot of plant derived emulsifying waxes or emulsifiers which are absolutely safe and biodegradable. I'm going to use the emulsifying wax which is called Olivium 1000 just because it's very common and easy to find. Next, active ingredients. Extracts, vitamins, humectants. Active ingredients helps to make your cream or lotion more effective. And today we're going to use an extract to make our cream more effective, more moisturizing, and to provide it with extra benefits for your skin. And the last group of ingredients, some they are called functional ingredients. Those are the ingredients that do not take care of your skin, but they're necessary to keep your product, to keep your emulsion safe and protected against different kind of mold or bacteria. We're talking about two ingredients that you always should use in your cosmetic formulation. Preservative, and it should be a broad spectrum preservative, and antioxidant. Normally we use vitamin E. It protects oils and butters and lipids in your cream from oxidation. Oh, it sounds so complicated, a lot of ingredients. Where do I buy all those ingredients? Please don't be scared, because actually today there are millions of websites that sell high quality cosmetic ingredients on small scale. Going to make a moisturizing cream for normal to oily skin. It's rather lightweight with light texture, but if you have a dry skin or mature skin like me, for example, you can change a little bit my formulation, and I'm gonna leave you the examples of formulations for dry skin and mature skin in the text box below this video. And first we are going to disinfect our tools, our working space, our beakers, because we want to make sure that we do not contaminate our product during the preparation process. What we're going to do right now, we're going to take two separate beakers, and we're going to weigh our water and our oils and emulsifier in a different beakers, and then we're going to put it on a water bath and heat it a little bit. So you take your scale, you put a disinfected beaker on it, make sure that you have zeros, and first we're going to weigh water. This is our water, and we just put it away for now and take another beaker. In this beaker we're going to weigh our oils, butter, and emulsifier. And first I'm going to add shea butter. After adding each ingredient, make sure you actually push the button, come back to zero. Now I'm going to add some jojoba oil. Put it back to zero, and the last one is sweet almond oil. now in the same beaker I'm going to add my emulsifier. So this is an oil phase of our cream. We have our emulsifier, our shea butter, jojoba oil and sweet almond oil. And this is our water. And now I'm going to put both of the beakers onto a water base and I'm going to melt my ingredients, my emulsifier, and heat a little bit our water. And then I'm going to combine it and make a cream. And to organize my water base, I use this IKEA steamer insert. Okay, my emulsifier and my butters are fully melted and now I'm going to add my oils to my water while constantly mixing. And we are going to whip it for a while, maybe 1 or 2 minutes. And this is a process of emulsifying. You see how it actually turns milky. What we're doing right now, we split oils into droplets and we spread it into our water. And then we're going to put it on a cold water base to speed up the process of emulsification. And we're going to let it cool down while constantly mixing our emulsion. And while your emulsion is cooling down, you're going to see that its texture is changing and becomes silkier. Very, very nice. Just keep mixing. And we have to cool down our emulsion till room temperature before adding our active ingredients, our preservative and our antioxidant. Our emulsion is almost ready. Look at the texture. You can check the temperature on your skin. And if it's okay, then you can actually proceed and add your preservative, vitamin E and our active ingredient, our extract. I put back my emulsion on my scale. And first I'm going to add my active ingredient. Now I have to mix it in very well. We have to spend some time here. We have to be sure that our extract is like really mixed in and spread. The texture of your cream might change a little bit. It might be a little bit runnier. This is normal because we have at 5% of water-based ingredient, but still the texture is very, very nice. And also the important thing is we are using glycerin, so it's glycerin based extract, and glycerin is a very nice cosmetic ingredient. It's a humectant, so actually it helps to hydrate your skin because it attracts moisture from the atmosphere. So I put my cream back on scale and now I'm going to add my preservative and my vitamin E. And the last ingredient, that's our essential oil. I put back my cream on scale and add my essential oil. We're almost good to go, the only one step left. Now we have to measure the pH of our cream and to make sure that it's around 5.5. You just take your stripe, put it inside your cream, just put it on the table and wait a little bit to read the result. Guys, our cream is ready. Look at this nice, creamy, light texture. Very nice. So we're all done here. So I'm going to put my cream into my bottle. That's it. You've just done your own face moisturizer. You can keep it up to 3 months and use it as a regular cream you buy at store. I hope you're going to enjoy the process of making your own cosmetics. If you found this video useful, please subscribe to my channel. If you still have any questions, please don't hesitate to ask them in the comments below this video, and we'll be happy to answer you. And see you next time.